Hey, what's up everybody? Too Tall Toby here, and today I just wanted to make a very short video to answer a question that I've been seeing a lot in the comments. And that question is, what is the difference between the Onshape free version and the Onshape paid versions? And the answer to that question can be found right on onshape.com. If you go up to the header bar here and you choose pricing, this will take you directly to a product matrix showing you the difference between the free version, the standard version, the professional version, and the enterprise version. Now, in this video, I'm not gonna go in and explain the difference between all four of these. You can see it right here. I really just wanted to give you some direction as to where you can find this product matrix. But the most important thing to point out here is that in the free version is really intended for non-commercial projects where all user data is stored in a public workspace. So this is great for students. This is great for people who are trying to learn Onshape, or maybe people who are just trying to learn 3D CAD for the first time. This is perfect. But anything that you create and store in your documents is going to be stored in a public workspace. So that means you don't want to store anything proprietary on that free version. If you're ready to start working with your actual projects and you need to protect your IP, then it's gonna be time to upgrade to either the standard or the professional version of Onshape. And it's good to know that when that time comes, you can use the request trial functionality for Onshape Professional. This way you and your team can begin testing the simulation capabilities, the rendering functionality, and the advanced data management tools that are found in Onshape Professional. You can even make that request for your entire team so that you can do some real world testing of the collaboration functionality found inside of Onshape Professional. So let me know down in the comments, do you have any additional questions about this topic? I'm happy to dive in a little deeper on any specific questions you might have, but I hope that helps to give you some direction, point you to where the product matrix is, and I'm looking forward to diving in a little bit deeper and learning about more of these nuances between these different versions. So I will see everyone in the next video.